since, yeah. Since I was really young, they were in high school, so she's known me since I was about 12 years old. They've been together since then. This is going to be hard for her, so Drew, you better get ready to stand up and help your mother. So, let's support Denise. Come on up and...
He didn't speak to me again for 4 months. Started calling in the fall of senior year, and he asked me out. He showed up 45 minutes late for our first date, and when he arrived, he had 4 other girls in the car. This would have raised multiple red flags for most people. But thankfully, I thought he was so cute and so sweet that I kept answering his phone calls. 8 years later, after a few stops and starts, we were married. By then, Andy was working at Armino Jones and Lombardi's little office in San Leandro. I didn't see him much during that time. He worked hard all the time. I was more than a tax widow, but I knew it came with the territory, and I knew the man I married. I knew he would do everything the best he knew how. Our first years of marriage were spent in Alameda. I was teaching and Andy was auditing, but we always knew we wanted to be parents. Our path to parenthood wasn't an easy one, but we faced those challenges together, and on June 26, 1993, we were blessed with our first son, Drew Joseph. Andy became proficient at changing diapers, reading Dr. Seuss at bedtime, and bathing a squirmy little baby. 4 years later, our princess, Sienna Marie, was born. Adorable but colicky, Andy soon discovered the genius remedy for all that crying. Exasperated after a particularly long bout of screaming, hers, not his, Andy laid her on a blanket on the dryer. It immediately stopped her crying. She was so soothed. When our sweet Dominic was born 2 years later, Andy was a pro. When I had to return to the hospital 3 weeks later in the middle of the night with a feverish baby, I knew our other two were in good hands. When we returned home a week later, the kids were still alive, the house was still standing, and everyone had clean underwear. I would consider that a success. Andy, watching you as a dad is one of my greatest joys. You are a wonderful father. No matter how many hours you spent at the office, you still found time to change diapers, coach t-ball and little league and basketball, go to Christmas performances and Indian princess meetings, school fundraisers, and every baseball, basketball, soccer, and lacrosse game that your schedule would allow. Over the years, you've taught our children how to ride bikes, ski, hunt, fish, and cook. But those are just a few of the physical skills. More importantly, you've modeled respect, integrity, honesty, faith, and charity. Most of you don't know this, but a couple of years ago, Andy started carrying $5 bills in his wallet. He would hand them out to people in parking lots and on off-ramps holding cardboard signs. You never know what people are going through, he would tell the kids. Now that our children are older, the relationship with them has changed. While you are still their father, there are fewer things we need to teach them. We learn more from them these days. The interaction is different. The conversations are more mature and involved. They seek your advice rather than just your approval. From you, they have learned the value of hard work. They have approached school and careers with that in mind. I know how proud you are of them. and you love hanging out with them. They bring out your silly side, which we don't get to see often enough, but maybe we will now that you're retiring. Andy, for me, you have always been a source of strength. There have been many times throughout my marriage when I have been very thankful for this. We view the world with different lenses at times, but that gives me a perspective that I wouldn't otherwise have. You've helped me been a better mother, daughter, wife, and friend. You encourage me to speak up, be strong, and not worry so much about what other people think. You are my best friend. You know me better than anyone else, and you still like hanging out with me, which is really good because we'll be hanging out a lot come January. Thank you for loving me and the kids with all that you have. Your last 30 years have been dedicated to your career here at the firm. You are an incredibly hard worker. As we like to say, you get shit done. You aren't afraid of long hours, missed meals, or challenging projects. You never complain, not about the work, the hours, or the people. I see how proud you are of this firm. I hope some of that pride comes from knowing that you're leaving after a job incredibly well done. I know how much you've enjoyed your time here at Armenino. Some people have a job, others have a career, but you've had a passion, and I know you feel very blessed for being able to pursue that passion the last 30 years. I know how much you will miss this firm. Maybe not the long hours, and probably not all of your clients, but the people, your people, here at Armenino. Many of your closest friends are in this room, and you will miss them. But don't worry. When your very type A personality starts to annoy my non-type A personality, I will schedule plenty of play dates for you. Andy, I am so incredibly happy for you. I celebrate you with you tonight. I have always felt so proud to be your wife. In the wise words of Dr. Seuss, you have brains in your head and feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose, so go for it. Congratulations.